quickly. No, not quickly. I'm going to give you all about 30 more seconds. Oh, Bass Flat also did this. Bass Flat. It is stone. Yeah. Yes, that's right. That's not as fast on the tape stone. That's good. Now this one, I believe this one is going to stump some people. In Azeroth. Good quick look up there, Tarkus. I'm glad you remember this stuff. Actually, I'll be honest, I don't know what happened with Rockard. Or even how to pronounce it. Is it Rockard or Rockard? Because I always say Stoner. Playing last year. I really hope that we can get a remaster of Warcraft 1. At some point, maybe with Microsoft taking over, it'll happen. We'll see. I do know that the team that did the Chronicles mod for Warcraft 3 that made Warcraft 2 in it is doing a quick and dirty reconstruction of Warcraft 1 in there. We'll see. Instead we get Smite 2. A lot of people are excited for Smite 2. I don't blame them for doing it. A lot of people are energized for it. I think Smite 2 is a good choice. As long as they don't do the Overwatch 2 thing where it's pretty much just a patch update, but they're charging people back for it. Hopefully that's not what happens, but I would love to see a remake of Warcraft 4. Especially if they keep in the road system that Warcraft 1 required. It was absolutely ridiculous and excessive, and I loved it. I absolutely loved it. It was fantastic. All right, continuing. We're in Warcraft 2 here. Warcraft 2 era of thinking. And you're going to have to do some typing on this. Because I'm going to want a list for a reply. Warcraft 2 introduced the rest of the Eastern Kingdoms to us. And so many more nations than just Azeroth or Stormwind. In one message, in one list of names, name at least four of those six new human nations that Warcraft 2 introduced. Go. We're gonna give you all some time on this one. I just need four. So the four easiest ones to remember and type out. Go. Also, congratulations to Frisky Guard for now owning the channel. Use your power wisely. We're gonna wait for people to type. Again, I need four of the six human nations that were introduced in Warcraft 2. Frisky Guard gets it. Yes. Those are four acceptable answers. Kul'Thuras, Alterac, Stromgarde, and Lordaeron. The other two were Gil'neas and Dalaran. Tarkus, I wouldn't have accepted Kirin Tor as an answer. I would need Dalaran. Kirin Tor is the leading council of Dalaran, but Dalaran is the actual nation. That one is going to Frisky Guard. That one was a lot. That question was a lot. A well-earned point. A very well-earned point. Now, going up to Warcraft 3. So this should be something that some people will remember. This is kind of esoteric, though, from Warcraft 3. Warcraft 3 had some interesting model choices for some in-game assets. Which human nation's logo was emblazoned on every single human tent throughout the entire game? This is really random and esoteric, and I don't know why Blizzard did this, but one nation's emblem is on every single tent model throughout all of Warcraft 3, and it's not Lordaeron. It is not Lordaeron. Maybe Reforge put Lordaeron's model on there, but it's not. That's not the original answer. Actually, I don't think Reforge changed this. This is a weird one. I don't know if you guys are going to get this. Never mind. I say I don't think you're going to get this, and then Tarkus gets it. It was Gil'neas. The giant black G is on every single tent model throughout all of Warcraft 3, and I have no idea why. I have no clue why. So right now, point totals. Vast Lad is in the lead with 4. Tarkus, right behind with 3. Frisky Guard, 2 points. You all are pretty much neck and neck there. You all are darn close. Next question. The central section of the Eastern Kingdoms, where the dwarves and gnomes call home, is named after what titan? What titan did the name for where the dwarves and gnomes call home Vasilek gets it. It was Khazgarov. Yes, Khazmodan is named after Khazgarov. That is absolutely correct. I don't know what Horov is. Pretty strong, if I remember right. Yeah, those were the two answers I was looking for there. Alrighty. Question 10. We're only in question 10? No, I've had bonus points. Where'd all the extra points come from? No? I know what I'm doing. Scott, I know what I'm doing. The first time here, oh goodness. Alright, next question. Just beyond the dark portal on the Draenor side lies a fortress to stop all incursions into Orcish homelands. What is the name of this fortress? Like, Hellfire Citadel was so much fun. Although, I should have assumed that you all played TBC. Did you all play TBC? Maybe that's not the best time to ask that question, but I'm curious. Good. Deeper into the lands of the Orcs, an immense citadel used to muster clans and send them off to war. In fortress was mistakenly remade into a Draenei burial site. What is the name of this fortress that the orcs had to muster clans and send them off to war? This is a personal... This one is a personal pet peeve of mine. It was Ogden Dude. That's like, you know, on the wall. God. So, the reason that... And we're going to take a break here shortly because I need to rest my voice. But, Ogden Dude was originally described as this immense orcish fortress that was used to rally clans and then direct them to...
Hey, for real.
The Dark Horde. That's what it was. And then suddenly in TBC, it became this burial settlement site that then got exploded because of Cooper getting summoned in. That kind of stuff makes me angry. That kind of stuff makes me a touch drunk. And Vasslad, that's true. Realize that it wasn't always a burial site, but I did want to include that to correct people to the correct answer. Because otherwise, if I hadn't said that, no one would have realized what it was. Four dungeons. It was four dungeons, Tarkus. Mana Tombs, Aconite Crypts, Sethic Halls, and the Shadow Lever. I did enjoy TBC. So TBC was so good for PvP. Like, a lot of people criticize the system of E-Logs and Rift Mines and keys you had to get. But I'm going to be honest, I love that stuff. I really love that stuff. Like, TBC was my favorite for PvE because of it. Don't get me wrong, I love vanilla. I really love vanilla. But the style that they went for with TBC with that was just... It was so good. It was so good. I loved it so much. Anywho, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a short clip of the songs here, and then we're gonna get back to round two of trivia here. First song we're gonna play is Lido Shuffle. I will. Let's go ahead. And load up Kings of Leon, Sex on Fire. Couple tracks, and then we're back to it here. Trivia night going on here on Turtle. Don't go anywhere. We're right back after this.
Yeah.
Ooh, that cuts off fast. I forgot how fast that cut off. Hello, welcome back. Welcome back, everyone. I'm Dan. We're doing Trivia Night here. If you do want to participate in Trivia Night, hop over to the Trivia Night channel. Just do /join Trivia Night. You'll be good to go. Currently, Vast Lad in the lead with 8 points. Tarkus with 3, and then Frisky Guard with 2. Vast Lad really taken off there. Really taken off. We're going to go ahead and skip over. And I'm going to cherry pick a couple more questions, because I do want to get to my second category today. And I'm not going to do that if we just keep going one after another. Give me just a second here. And I need to mark the ones that we have done. There we go. Okay. Alrighty, once again, if you're interested in participating in Trivia Night here, win some turtle coinage, some turtle tokens, join the Trivia Night channel. Join the Trivia Night channel, and you'll be able to respond. With that being said, though, let's get right back into it here. Hopefully everyone is back from that break. Next question. We're going to see how many people are paying attention here. Obviously, Warcraft 3 Reforged came out a couple years ago. Really brought Warcraft 3 back into the spotlight. Unfortunately, they reconstructed some things that were not accurate to Warcraft 3 and how it was presented. So I am specific.